I can't be super cliche. I can't just be like, be the change you want to see in the world. Even though, like, I mean, I really do mean it.
I know.
Yeah. 4 years ago, I saw firsthand the crippling effects of drought. People's wells ran dry. They had to truck water in for even basic water needs. If I painted that picture, that's something you would think is happening in a third world country. But it happened right here in California, in the United States. It really hit home and it made me really want to do something to help. I started thinking, is it possible for us to reuse or recycle the water that we've already got in our homes? And that's what led me to start thinking about gray water. Gray water is any lightly used water from sinks, showers, laundries, water that you've used once in your home but you can use again. I was most interested in gray water from the laundry simply because that's the easiest to reuse. Through a laundry to lawn system, you can take the gray water and put that out for irrigation without needing a permit or without needing to filter the water. In an average American household, about 30% of the water used is for outdoor purposes. So just by reusing gray water, you're saving a huge amount by doing that. However, many commercial laundry detergents have harmful chemicals in them. So if I wanted to reuse gray water as a method of water conservation, then I needed to find an alternative solution. When my grandma came to visit from India, she brought with her the berry shell of the Indian soap berry. They're called soap nuts. You put them in water and they'll actually release soap. She wanted to see if I could use them for washing my hair. Instead, I made soap out of them and used them as an alternative laundry detergent. I've spent countless hours in the lab running tests, counting colonies on plates, taking samples, just to make sure that gray water is safe. What I found through my years of testing is that yes, we really can use it. It's a viable solution, which is really awesome.
We have Shreya here. She's an American high school student. She's in 10th grade. To talk to you guys about why is it important to recycle water and how we do that.
I think introducing kids to water conservation and water recycling is one of the most important things we can do. I created a curriculum for elementary school students that teaches them where their water comes from, how they're using it in their homes, and where it goes after. I want to make water recycling just as normal as paper or plastic recycling. And that's really the paradigm shift that I want to initiate. Not everyone goes to places where drought is really prominent. Not everyone goes to places where you see people actually suffering from water scarcity. But people should still know that that's a problem. If there's something that you want to change, then go out there and do it. If you don't try to make a difference, then who will?